Hey there, everybody. So my nationality is Hungarian. Well, it's 50-50, Hungarian and Russian. When I was growing up, my grandmother, Hungarian grandmother from Budapest, Hungary, she made stuffed cabbage. So I figured, well, you know what? I'm gonna give you all a quick lesson on how to make stuffed cabbage. You take the head, I already did this, sorry guys, but of the cabbage, and you throw it into a pot of boiling water, and you cover it, and you let it get nice and soft. Then you go ahead and peel off the leaves. And right here, there's a thick vein. You want to go ahead and you want to, I already did it. You want to cut that away so it bends nicely, okay? There you go. The mixture, the stuffing, which is the meat, it's chopped meat, onions that were sautéed to be transparent, rice, minute rice, 1 cup, 2 pounds of meat, and salt and pepper. So there you go, that's the stuffing, and now I'm gonna show you how to roll. You ready? Let's see. All right. Okay, so we have a leaf. Baby love. And we're gonna go ahead and we're going to make like a ball. Can you see that? Nice little size, right? You want some meat in it. See? You put it right in there. See? Lollipop. And you do it tight. Roll it. And then tuck the sides. And tuck the other side. And roll it. Now it's much easier when you do this on a flat surface, but I just wanted to show you. You gotta tuck it, and then, guys, you've got a stuffed cabbage. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm rolling it, and we'll be back. And we went ahead and we are done rolling the cabbage. So the next is, with Hungarians, we use sauerkraut. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna chop up all of this extra cabbage. And in the olden days, they didn't have any of these, you know, crazy sauces. So I remember my grandmother was using Hunt tomato sauce. Excellent. And we're just gonna go ahead and we are going to start layering next, guys. That's what we're doing. Pans ready. Beautiful cabbages are ready. Sauerkraut, cabbage, and we're gonna start cutting up the cabbage. This was the extra. Let's see? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we have the chopped up cabbage, and remember what I said, that after you soften the cabbage in hot boiling water and you remove it, you go ahead and you remove the vein. So here are the veins. I kept them because they're part of the cabbage, right? So nothing is wasted. Back in the day, they didn't waste anything. So we don't waste anything either, right? So we have that, and now we're going to go ahead and we're going to layer. We're going to have some kraut, cabbage, right? And then we're going to also add sauerkraut. Okay. I'm just gonna squeeze it, but I don't wanna squeeze it dry because I like the taste of the sauerkraut and the juice, right? We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna layer. Now it's the sauerkraut that makes it Hungarian, babies. All right? And now, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to top it off with a little bit of sauce. Hold on. All right. Okay. Put the sauce on it. Just as a layer, nice little layer. Nothing Nothing crazy because everything's gonna... See? Beautiful, right? Mm-hmm. And now we're gonna take the cabbages and we're gonna place them gently. Gently. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And because I didn't really make a lot, I'm going to space them out. Yeah. That pretty? It's pretty. And just like anything else, I'm gonna take cabbage. And all we're doing is we're layering, right? We're layering. Bringing all this yumminess all together. And I still have all this yummy lettuce too. This cabbage. And take the coleslaw and strain it a little. Drain it a little. Sauce. Sauce. Nice. Nice. Very nice. Very nice. Okay. And... One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And now we're going to take the remaining cabbage, going to top it. Right, and then I'm gonna take this remaining cabbage here and chop it up. Check it out. Beautiful, right? Beautiful. Wonder how it smells. For those of you that don't know, I don't smell. So it normally takes, for this recipe, 3 cans of tomatoes. So I got one really big one and another, which equals 3. Now we go ahead and we put it on the oven, on the stovetop. Check it out. Oh, let that go right down all by its little self. Huh. Yeah, it's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. See? Says I need to put in some sugar. A little bit of salt and a little bit of lemon juice. Okay. Oh, those hurricanes, the hurricanes, the Hungarians and the sugar. Sugar. All right. What the sugar does is it takes away from the acid of the sauerkraut. Did you know that? Italians use sugar in their sauce too. Okay, I think that's good. I like how they top it off and then it just, everything just seeps down, right? And they said a little bit more salt. So I know I don't need a lot of that. Okay, and lemon juice. All right, guys. To be continued. I wish you guys could smell this. I wish I could smell it. And there we go. So now that it's at a really nice boil, I'm going to go ahead and turn it down to medium low. Okay, medium low. And that's it, guys. That's stuffed cabbage, Hungarian style.